朋友，今天的最后一道是叫做 Chendol 的一个甜品，相信很多人都很喜欢吃 Chendol 哈，在街上到处都有的卖。不过如果能够在自己家里做的话呢，就会比较卫生，也比较可口好吃。So ladies and gentlemen, the last dish that I would like to show you is Chendol. It's a very popular dessert in Malaysia. Normally, you can buy Chendol at the roadside stall, but if you find that if you prepare it at home, it is healthier. So these are the ingredients. 大家请看哦，今天要做 Chendol 要用到的材料就是100g 的粟米粉，就是 corn flour. This is 100g of corn flour.然后还要用到的就是20g 的红桂粉，也就是绿豆粉。This is 20g of 红桂 flour, which you can buy in this form. 你去 supermarket 就有了哈。你可以买白色的或者是青色的。It comes in two forms. You can buy either white one or the green color one. And this is 20g of 当明粉，这就是20g 的豆面粉。还有就是一小匙的盐 ，one teaspoon of salt, and half a teaspoon of alkaline water.就是半小匙的碱水。那这里呢，有36盎司的潘旦叶水。这潘旦叶水就是用十片的潘旦叶加水来打成的。So this is 36 ounces of pandan juice. This pandan juice is taken from 10 pieces of pandan leaves, and you liquidize it with the water, and you squeeze out 36 ounces.If you find that it's not green enough, you can add in a little bit of green coloring. 这个青色素就是如果你觉得它不够青色，那么你才加入一点点。好，现在呢，我们就是把全部的材料跟它搅拌均匀。So first of all, you have to mix all the ingredients together.好，全部把它搅拌均匀以后，最要紧的就是那个盐哦，要全部融化。然后我们就是把它放倒在一个锅子里面，倒去的时候就要紧要跟它沥过。Yes, strain everything into a pot and make sure there's no flour, 一点粉都没有哦。好，现在我们就可以把这个料拿去煮了。Yes, ladies and gentlemen.You have to pour everything into a pot, and now you have to stir and bring it to boil. 那大家请看哈，你一定要不断的搅拌，不然的话它就不会化。It is very important that you have to stir continuously. And when you stir, please stir right to the bottom. 不要忘记哈，搅的时候应该是搅到它的底，而且最好就是用个平的铲，那么它就能够铲到全部的地方。大家看到吗？它已经滚了哈，看到吗？就是这样滚。Yes, you have to bring it to boil like this. 让它滚几分钟哈，不是一滚就拿起来哦，记得哦。Remember, don't take it out once it is boiled. You have to keep stirring for another 2 to 3 minutes. 再搅多两三分钟。那么这个粉团呢，就会非常非常的滑，吃起来呢也会 QQ 的哦，很好吃。This is a time when you can turn off the fire. 那这时候我们就可以把火关掉了。那现在呢，我们就要准备怎么样来做成一条一条的 chendol。煮做这个 chendol， 你应该是有一个盘，这个盘上面呢有一个一个的小洞哈，这就是拿来做。Chendol 的盘，如果你说哎呀我家里没有，那么怎么办呢？那么如果你家里有一个窝，因为现在有很多这种杠窝，它上面呢有一个蒸笼，它就有这个一个一个的小洞的，是吗？如果你有这个的话，那么你就用这个。它的洞呢不要拿太大的那种窝，有太大的洞的，那么你做出来的 Chendol 就会很大条。 Ladies and gentlemen, this is a Chendol mold. If you don't have this style of mold in the house, you can always useyour steamer. You know, nowadays in the house, many people have this type of stainless steel steamer, which have small tiny holes for steaming things. So you can use that. The bottom part, you place the water and you put in some ice. 在里面呢，我们就准备一点的水哈，然后放一些冰块。那么水呢是冰冰的，等一下我们的拳头一跌下去的时候，它很快就会凝结，很快就会硬。 好，现在我们就是把它倒进去。So now you pour in all the mixture. Then you can use anything that is flat, and then you just have to press it down. You just have to press it down like this. 大家请看哦，它就会一条一条的跌下去哦，看得到吗？我这样看，你看得到吗？ It will drop down and form into chendol. 那各位朋友，大家看到吗？这就是已经做好了的 chendol. So this is a completed chendol, and you leave it in the ice water until it is firm. Then after that, you can serve it with gula melaka and coconut milk. 这里就让它去凝结，然后我们就要准备一个椰浆以及我们的椰糖。好，大家请看哦，煮它的椰糖，我们需要用到的就是350 g 的椰糖。This is 350 g of palm sugar, or we call it gula melaka. Just cut it into pieces. Remember, you buy the long one, now with the hollow in the center. That is the genuine gula melaka.要买好的椰糖，就是买那个长长的、中间有洞的那个椰糖，它就是真正的椰糖。然后再加150 g 的糖 ，This is 150 g of sugar， and this is 1 cup of water。然后就是一杯的水，把这三样东西拿去煮溶它。Bring it to boil, and to add in more frequent, you add in.3 pieces of pandan leaf， 使到这椰糖吃起来更加的香。这里呢，我们就是准备3片的椰子。这斑斓叶记得哦，一定要跟它撕开来，那么它会比较香。给它打成一个结 ，tie into a knot， and then you put it in。在煮糖的时候，就让我们来看看我们的椰浆。今天要用到的就是一粒半或者是2粒的椰子都可以，然后加入3杯的冷开水，把它挤出那个椰浆，然后就加入1小匙的盐，跟它搅拌均匀。So this is 2 coconuts, add in 3 cups of cold water, cold boiled water, and then you squeeze out the coconut milk. Then you add in 1 teaspoon of salt, and you stir.If you add in salt into your coconut milk, you find that your coconut milk can last longer. 如果你把盐加在椰浆里面，那么你的椰浆就能够保持久一点，它就不会这样容易变酸。好，这就是我们今天要用到的椰浆。我们的糖液呢也好了。Yes, you can see that our gula melaka syrup is also ready. This gula melaka.Syrup, you need to strain it before you use. 现在我们可以把火关掉哈，可以把它沥过，然后呢，我们就可以吃了。煮好了的 chendol 就是把它放在一个小碗里面，这是当做个甜品吃的哈。那碗不需要太大，然后就是把我们的椰浆倒下去。So you can serve your chendol with small bowls. It is used as a dessert. Then you add in the coconut milk. 然后就是把我们的椰浆放在里面。And then you top with a bit of sugar syrup. 然后就再加一点的椰糖在上面。你要放多少椰糖就是看你自己喜欢了哈。喜欢吃甜的就放多一点。Then you add in some gula melaka syrup. The sweetness depends on your own taste. 好，这是今天为大家介绍的一个很好吃的 chendol， 是一个很特别的甜品。So I'm sure you will like the chendol which I just introduced to you. It is a very popular dessert in Malaysia.朋友，今天为大家介绍的牛轧粿，希望大家都会喜欢，尤其是 Seri Mukhe， 就是双层的糯米糕， 看了我的这个示范之后，希望大家在家里都能够成功的做成。因为很多朋友就说，在我的这本街边风味小吃的做法呢，很多人就是不明白要怎么样来蒸，使到它的上面那一层呢会比较结实，就是记得哦，不要用到太大的火来蒸就没有问题了。 Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed the Nyonya series today, especially the making of Seri Muka, because many people say that by following the recipe in my Hawker's Delight, they cannot get the top part of the Seri Muka right. So today, I've shown you how to makethe Seri Muka successfully. What is important is don't use high fire to steam the top part, then it will definitely be successful. So till I see you again, bye bye.